So now finally our last drug is caffeine, which is normally present in your coffee, a mug of coffee. Okay. So these are CNS stimulant primarily affecting the higher centers of brain. Basically, they produce a sense of well-being, alertness, beats boredom, allays fatigue, and thinking becomes clearer. Okay. So what is the mechanism of action? So they are mainly inhibiting an enzyme phosphodiesterase. Okay. Now what is the role of phosphodiesterase? They are responsible for metabolism of cyclic AMP. Okay. So basically what these drugs are doing, they are increasing the availability of cyclic AMP. So they thus increases intracellular cyclic AMP and produces effects that mimics those of the mediators that stimulates adrenal cyclase. Okay. So what comes in your mind when I say regarding cyclic AMP and adrenal cyclase? Yes, the G protein coupled receptor, isn't it? That too, G stimulatory kind. Okay. So taking a very simple example of G protein coupled receptor, which is your adrenergic receptor, isn't it? So they are, these drugs basically increases the action of adrenergic system. Okay. So what happens when adrenaline or adrenergic kind of drug binds with this G protein coupled receptor? It will cause activation of the enzyme adrenal cyclase. And what this adrenal cyclase will do? It will convert ATP into cyclic AMP. Okay. Now there will be an enzyme known as phosphodiesterase enzyme, which will cause metabolism of cyclic AMP. So whatever action which is about to be produced by cyclic AMP, like phosphorylation of a protein, activation of protein kinase, release of calcium, and so on and so forth, that is to be inhibited. Okay. So we are, what this caffeine is doing, it is inhibiting phosphodiesterase enzyme. Okay. So when this enzyme is inhibited, we will get a good availability of cyclic AMP, and all the actions which are mediated by cyclic AMP will be produced by caffeine. Okay. And all those actions are nothing but your CNS stimulant effects. Okay.